Oh, yes.
Good morning, boys and girls. We are playing Alfred Chicken on the NES. So I'm just looking over there because the pillow on my new couch is fucking out. I know, I could hear the music in my head before I started. Hey, sounds pretty good. Sounds pretty much like the emulation as I remember it. It's a bit brown, but we'll get there. Okay. Hey, it plays nice. Yeah, it plays nice. I mean, Alfred Chicken was always quite a slow game. Look, I don't remember how to kill stuff. Ah, is it pull down? Yeah, there we go. So you gotta pull down. It was always quite a slow platformer. Weirdly, a game that I always really liked. I think I always liked it for a certain amount of time before I had enough of it. And I think that'll probably happen in this video. But this is a great platformer, I think. I really enjoyed it back in the day when I first played it. I just warmed to it straight away. It feels like a rich, deliberate platformer. Like, it's everything that happens in it is very, very well kind of designed and laid out. And the mechanics are good. I remember like, that's a picnic, I think. I've got to remember what to do with it. All these little touches. These little charming touches. I remember the peckiness but that. Can't remember what the point of that is. But it'll come to me. And there's like an element of... Go on, Alfred. Yes. I love his name. I love the way he looks. I love his cute. I love his music. That was lucky. Clearly the collision boxes were. They're being generous with the collision in this. And I have no problem with that. I love it. It's got like, everything ties together well in this game, I think. And it's also suitably an underdog of a game, and I love the underdog. I love the unspotted gem, and I think Alfred Chicken was a bit of that. I think it was a bit of a gem that people didn't really notice. This version's a very good version, actually. It makes me wonder what. The computer version would be like, would have been like, it did never come across it very late in bits like this. This is a very, unlike that Aladdin, which is a terrible port, this is a very well made port. The graphics aren't all that because the NES graphics, but they're getting a lot of colouring, all things considered. There's a lot of variety in the colour. It's clearly pushing the NES to its colour limit. And you know, you've got to appreciate that. Loving it, absolutely loving it. This is as good a version as you could come to expect from the NES. And everything's there, you know, everything that I would have thought. Everything that was in the Amiga version so far, pretty much. Everything that mattered is here. This is great. The chicken, yeah. Who thought it even existed? I thought this was a bit late. This was after like the Super Pod on the Amiga. This was after. I played this in the early 90s, so I've got the Amiga 92, fair enough. But I played this about 93, 94. Everything I got for the Amiga, I'm suspecting was late in both those machines' lives. And there was kind of a different quality of game later on. I think a better quality of game, but I know, for example, Spectrum people appreciated the really old stuff more than the new stuff. The hardcore kind of Spectrum love, and that's fine. But I prefer the new stuff. I was like a Midnight Resistance loving, you know, Batman the Movie loving kind of kid of the Spectrum when other people were into Manic Miner and Jetpack. You know, Jetpack was pretty good. But it's time for Jetpack. But, same applied to the Amiga. While people were into the likes of Dungeon Master and you know the early comers and the kind of early games, I was into the later ones, the Lionhearts and the Wolfchilds. And you know the stuff that came later on. I was more of a Swift kid than a Silkworm kid, if that makes sense. I think that's a good start. Just get peasants. Pick up the peasants, Alfred. And Alpha Chicken was one of those later Amiga games, so I would never have expected it to turn up on the NES. But I think it shows what a good quality game it was, and you know, how the later games on the Amiga, on the 16-bits, could translate well to 3-bits, and I always wanted to see the Super Frogs, the Wolf Child, the, you know, the later games of the 16-bit era turned up on 8-bits. So I took to draw inspecting versions of those games and other games, even games that existed like eSpot, which I think a few more of account because I'm busy dealing with this level. But yeah, even those, as reimagined Pit Fighter stuff that we did, you know, badly, I'd reimagine with full colour perspective. I've talked about it before, I think I'm in a little while ago. I might it's worth me digging out some of those and showing you and talking. I'm gonna talk for a while. I meant to show off some more Amiga discs, but I still need up to the attic and the attic to get them. So that's gonna have to wait. But I do have access to, like, look at that. I think we better get out of here. Oh no, sorry. His explosion is limited. I don't even remember him. So that has been a while. So yeah, maybe I'll show you some of those screenshots I did for some old games. One in particular I did actually make in full was called Max 2 from Minecraft, which I was one of the people who loved that game. It wasn't that well received because it wasn't that big a change from Gold Max, I guess. Uh-oh. Let's just see if I can go back. Now that I've done some damage in here. No, I can't. Oh, yeah, I can. Oh, I've could have just gone. Never mind. I pressed down instead of down on the doors. For some reason. Wasn't paying attention, I guess. But up would make more sense. It's still brilliant, I don't care. It's still brilliant. Uh-oh. Oh, look, you mean about the shield? I think it just takes a hit for you if you get hit. Where's the lift? There it comes. I did a version of Gold Max 2 for Spectrum. I coded it in ShortPlay because I'm not a coder. I'm in particular not a Spectrum coder, but I can code in ShortPlay just because I've done it for years. Well, that's a baby. Oh, help. Right, I'm rescuing that baby. I've got to show you that something, haven't I? I think I'll start with some screenshots and Spectrum stuff, though, that I just have to dig them out. That's going to be fun. It's going to take a bit of time. Oh, it is off to get through the door. I don't know why I'm pushing down to get through the door. I'm the one being the unintuitive there. Where's that lifting? That was lucky. There it is. Yeah, I'll dig some of them out. But it's great to see this game is one of those 16-bit games that made it to the NES. I didn't even notice it in the games list. I was just like, oh, I'll put a chicken. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's good. And then, not bounce. And then it didn't hit me that, you know, this shouldn't really exist in the NES. This was after. And then surely, this was like 90s and this was 80s. It's a really good version. It's a spot on version, in fact. They've got it spot on. This is as good as it could be. Yeah, I rescued a chick and now I'm stuck. And now I have to die. Well, I'm going to leave it there because I can hear my family waking up and that's my cue to get involved. But what an awesome course. What a great place to leave it. Alfred Chicken on the NES. Thanks for watching.